Today we will be doing an experiment to find the focal length of concave lens using a convex lens. So the apparatus needed are optical bench, four uprights, concave lens, convex lens, meter scale, pins, lens holder and a mirror holder. Apparatus required: an optical bench, four uprights, a meter scale, lens holder, again a lens holder, a convex lens of very short focal length, concave lens which should have greater focal length than the convex lens, and two needles. Now this is a convex lens. An object O is placed in front of the convex lens. It will form an inverted image I at this place. So this is the first step. So after we obtain an image of an object O which is formed at I, then we have to place a concave lens just before the image I. That means you have the image I is here, so you have to place the concave lens just before the image I. Since this is a diverging lens, this will form an image at I dash. So you will get an image over here at I dash. Now in this case, this image I that was supposed to be kept over here will act as the object for the concave lens by measuring the distance between the I to the concave lens. We get U, and by measuring the distance of I dash from the concave lens we get a distance V. Then F can be calculated by using the formula 1 by F is equal to 1 by V minus 1 by U, or F is equal to UV divided by U minus V. Here a particular precaution has to be taken into consideration. Convex lens should have lesser focal length while concave lens should have greater focal length. Calculate the focal length of a convex lens by distant object method. So here you can see that we are trying to obtain a sharp inverted image. So now let us calculate the approximate distance of the focal length of the convex lens. So here we can see that we get a sharp image here, and the approximate distance is 10 centimeter, which means that the focal length of this convex lens is 10 centimeter. This is a concave lens, so you can see here it is narrower at the center and broader at the edges. So if I place this concave lens here and try to focus a distant object, here you can see that nothing is being obtained, which shows that a concave lens cannot obtain an image on the screen. That means it has got a virtual focus. So to calculate the focal length of a concave lens, we should take the help of a convex lens. Approximate focal length of the convex lens is 10 centimeter. So after finding the focal length of the convex lens, which is found to be 10 centimeter, place it in the upright, secure it with the screw, and see that the height of the both the needles in the uprights are approximately same. So here I can see they are approximately same. Now you can place this needle, which can act as an object, at a distance of 2f from the focal length. So the focal length was 10 centimeter. So therefore means from the concave lens, I will place this at a distance of 20 centimeter. So during the experiments, you can shuffle the distance between f and 2f. So you can keep it somewhere between 1.5 times to 2 times. So to begin with the experiment, I will keep it at 2f. That means here on the optical bench, I will place it at a marking of 10 centimeter. So you can see the marking is at 10 centimeter. That means this object is placed at a 10 centimeter marking. The distance between this convex lens and this object is 20 centimeter. So you can see that the convex lens has been placed on the marking of 30 centimeter. So the object is placed at a marking of 10 centimeter. That means from the convex lens, the object is placed at a distance of 2f, 20 centimeter. Now you can try to locate the inverted image of the object through the convex lens. So here I can see an inverted image of the object through the convex lens. Now you can see the inverted image of the object through the convex lens. By adjusting this upright along the optical bench, find a convenient location or position where you can see that the tip of this upright and tip of the image seen through the convex lens comes in one single straight line. So here I can see they come in one single straight line, but the tips are not meeting point to point. So I can make a slight adjustment by lifting it slightly up. Now I can see that the tip of the upright and the tip of the image needle seen through the convex lens meet at a single point. Now you can see the tips of the image needle seen through the convex lens and this upright are in the same straight line and they meet together. But now if I move my head to the either side, I can see there is a relative shift in their positions, which can be called as a parallax error. That means now I have to move this upright again to and fro without changing the positions of the convex lens and the object needle. I have to move this upright along the optical bench, find a convenient place and make fine adjustments by turning the screw so that the parallax is completely removed. Now by making a fine adjustments and by slightly moving this along the optical bench, I can find a convenient location where both the needles move together in one direction. That means the parallax can be said to be removed here. So at this particular location, I can see that the parallax is removed. Now at this position, the parallax has been removed, so you can see for the lateral shift. You can change the direction of your head to the either side and you can see both the pins move together. That means the parallax has been removed. So the parallax has been removed and you got an inverted image of the object needle at this position. So here see, on the optical bench, it's a marking of 50 centimeter. Now take a concave lens and place it on the optical bench in between the convex lens and the position where you had got an image I. Now here I will place this convex lens at a distance of 42.7 centimeter. So it is 42.5, 42.7 centimeter. So I have placed the convex lens at a distance of 42.7 centimeter. So this is the concave lens, and this was the position where the image was formed only because of the convex lens. Now the distance between this concave lens and this upright will give you the object distance, that is u. So this distance from the concave lens to this upright is the u. The concave lens was placed at a location of 42.7 centimeter on the optical bench. This upright was positioned on 50 centimeter. So the difference between them will give us the object distance. So 50. Now this upright where the image I was formed, now this will act as a object for the concave lens. That means since a concave lens is a diverging lens, the image obtained will be greater than this distance. So somewhere around at this particular position you can obtain a image as seen from the concave lens. Try to locate the position of the inverted image. So this is the inverted image seen through the concave lens, and move the upright and try to see that they are in one straight line. Now look for the parallax error by shifting your head to the either directions. Now by shifting to the either directions, you can see that there is a parallax error. So by moving this upright to and fro along the optical bench, find a convenient location where the parallax can be completely be removed. At this particular position, I can see that the parallax has been completely removed. That means both the inverted image of the needle and this upright both move together. So you can see here. Now at a distance of 56.9 centimeter, you can see the parallax has been removed. So you can see both the upright and the image needle here, both of them move together in the same directions as we move our head to the either sides. So the parallax has been removed. The concave lens was positioned at 42.7 centimeter. The upright position where the parallax was removed is 56.9 centimeter. So you can see that the distance between this concave lens and this upright will give us the image distance. So the difference between these values, 56.9 centimeter minus 42.7 centimeter, will give us 14.2 centimeter. That means the image distance V is equal to 14.2 centimeter. Now you can also see that previously this was placed at a distance of 50 centimeter. That means now this image has been slightly shifted to a further distance. So we could see that as per the experiment, the object was kept at a distance of 10 centimeter on the optical bench. The convex lens denoted by L1 was placed at 30 centimeter. We got the image at 50 centimeter. Then when we kept a concave lens L2 in between the image I and the convex lens L1, now we could see that the image I dash is shifted to a further distance because the concave lens acts as a diverging lens. So here the concave lens was placed at 42.7 centimeter and the obtained image was at 56.9 centimeter. So you can see here u is equal to 50 minus 42.7 is equal to 7.3 centimeter. V is equal to 56.9 minus 42.7 is equal to 14.2 centimeter. Substituting these values in the equation, F1 is equal to UV divided by U minus V. So 7.3 into 14.2 divided by 7.3 minus 14.2, we get a focal length of minus 15.02 centimeter. So you can input the values in the observation table.
and calculate the value of f for the first reading, focal length f1 is equal to minus 15.02 centimeter.
The object is kept at a location of 10 cm on the optical bench for the previous reading. Now shift it by 1 cm. That means now the object is placed at a location of 11 cm on the optical bench. That means the distance between the convex lens and the object has been decreased by 1 cm and now it is 19 cm, the difference between them. Try to locate the inverted image of the lens through this side, then moving this upright along the optical bench, try to find a convenient position where the tip of the image needle seen through the convex lens and the tip of this upright falls in a straight line. Shift your head to the either position, check for the parallax, again move it to and fro and locate a convenient position where the parallax is completely removed. So at a marking of 51.6, we can see that the inverted image seen through the lens actually coincides with the tip of this upright and the parallax has been completely removed. So you can see here at a distance of 51.6, the parallax has been removed. So it is at 51.6 centimeter. Repeat the procedure again by keeping the concave lens in between the image formed previously and the convex lens at a distance of 45.2 centimeter. So you can keep it at any distance. Here I am taking it as 45.2 centimeter. So the convex lens is kept at a distance of 45.2 centimeter. Now you can see previously when the image was formed at 51.6 centimeter, now actually it should move back, that the image will be formed slightly behind. So you can again focus and try to see the image. Try to locate the inverted image of the needle through the concave lens. And this is the upright here. So you know that the image will be shifted because the concave lens acts as a diverging lens. Now by moving this upright along the optical bench to and fro, find a convenient position where the parallax can be removed. So you can see here right now there is a parallax and this parallax has to be removed. That means the tip of the image needle seen through the concave lens and this tip of the upright should move together when we move our head in the either directions. So on moving the upright along the optical bench, it is found that at a location of 56 centimeter on the optical bench, this parallax is completely removed. So you can see both the image needle and the tip of the upright needle both moves in the same direction without any relative shift. Now you can see here it is on the location of 56 centimeter. So we can check our observations now. When the concave lens was not inserted and we could see that the image of this object needle was obtained at a distance of 51.6 centimeter, and then when the concave lens was included in the setup, we could see that it was located at a position of 45.2 centimeter. Then the image had to gradually shift a little further to this side. So now the image has shifted by some measurements. Now that means the image formed I dash is at a distance of 56 centimeter. So as per the observation, we can see that the object was shifted by 1 centimeter. So now it is 11 centimeter on the optical bench. Convex lens L1 is placed exactly at the same spot, 30 centimeter. So now the image is obtained at 51.6 centimeter, that is image I. In the second setup, we can see that when a concave lens was introduced, L2, in between the image I and the convex lens, the image I will actually get shifted to a further distance because concave lens is a diverging lens. So now the new image formed is I dash. And here, if the concave lens is placed at 45.2 centimeter, we obtain an image I dash at 56 centimeter. So the distance between the image and the concave lens is represented by U. So U is equal to 51.6 minus 45.2 is equal to 6.4 centimeter. Similarly, the distance between the image I dash and the concave lens is represented by V. So V is equal to 0 minus 45.2 is equal to 10.8 centimeter. Now putting these values in the above equation, F2 is equal to UV divided by U minus V, we get 6.4 into 10.8 divided by 6.4 minus 10.8, and we get an answer of minus 15.70 centimeter. Repeat the same procedure as we had done for finding F1 and F2. Now the object is again shifted by 1 centimeter. That means the object is at 12 centimeter on the optical bench. Convex lens L1 is kept at 30 centimeter, and we obtain the image of this object here at image I at a distance of 53 centimeter. So in the second setup, we can see that now a concave lens L2 is included at a distance of 48.0 centimeter. Now the image I is shifted to a further distance. So we can see here now it is shifted at a distance of 55.5 centimeter. Now you can see here again the difference between the image I and the concave lens is U is 53 minus 48 is equal to 5 centimeter. The difference between the image I dash and the concave lens is given by V, that is 55.5 minus 48 is equal to 7.5 centimeter. Substituting these values in the equation, F3 is equal to UV divided by U minus V, we get 5 into 7.5 divided by 5 minus 7.5 is equal to minus 15 centimeter. So you can see here the approximate focal length of the convex lens was found to be 10 centimeter. Object position, position of the convex lens, image formed by the convex lens, position of the concave lens, image formed when the concave lens was kept. This is the observed U. Next, you have corrected U, image distance V observed, corrected image distance V, and the formula F is equal to UV divided by U minus V. After having all the values input into the tabular column, you can see here F1 is calculated as minus 15.02 centimeter, F2 is minus 15.70 centimeter, F3 is minus 15 centimeter. Mean focal length F is equal to F1 plus F2 plus F3, you get minus 15.24 centimeter. Result, the focal length of given concave lens F is equal to minus 15.24 centimeter.